name is John McGiffin from Deep Recognition. Welcome to this presentation. Today we're going to be covering off our vehicle make, model, colour and year of manufacture recognition solution. I'm going to take you into a bit of a deep dive into that in terms of and explain how it actually works. So the agenda for today is we're going to be going through an introduction about deep recognition, tell you a bit more about us. Also covering off the fact that AI is really now more than just security. It's beneficial to lots of different areas within a business. How we scale artificial intelligence with Milestone. We're going to be then covering off the vehicle make, model, colour and year of manufacture analytics overview. And then followed by a couple of use cases. So we'll play you a couple of videos that have been done with personalized and relevant billboard advertising. And the second one is our high accuracy vehicle recognition using multi-factor vehicle recognition to outperform license plate recognition. So all these are using Milestone, which we use to record video footage from the cameras, but also, as you'll see through the SDK and Milestone, we integrate with Milestone and we can pull video feeds out, pull sections of video or imagery out of the video feeds as well, giving us really strong capabilities to integrate in lots of different ways. So a bit about deep recognition. So first of all, as you'll see in our recognition of the service architecture, which is our name for our platform, first of all, down the bottom, we work with a number of sensors. It could be lasers, people counters, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, e-tags, scanning. We bring in data. And we're also very good at working with cameras. So what we would typically do is we add in an appliance down here. You'll see this box, the edge-based analytics and RaaS capture engine. This is what pulls in the feeds from the cameras or from Milestone using the SDK, pulls that in, and we're starting to look for faces, license plates, weapons, a whole heap of different objects, including we can also process video through this as well. So when we detect, say, a face or a license plate, let's talk about license plates because we are talking about vehicle make and model recognition. When we see that, we pull out the license plate, we send it off to our broker, and our broker goes, oh, that's a license plate. I'm going to send a license plate recognition. If it was a face, it would send a facial recognition. If it was a weapon, send a weapons recognition. So essentially, deep recognition, we're a recognition platform company. We have the ability to bring a whole heap of different AI engines together and run them on the one platform. Now, sitting over the top of this, we're using Kafka or PubSub as a way of pulling out data from those engines. So if we recognize a particular license plate, ABC123, then we can generate an event. And that event can then be written back to Milestone and injected into the alarm panel so that the security guys then don't need to jump out of the console they're very familiar with. Sitting up the top of this, we then have our correlation engine, and I'll cover that in a bit more detail. Metadata is incredibly important for everything we do, so we have metadata engine, and then we have a configuration engine as well, which sits there to make sure that we're plumbing all these things through, and we can very easily, just by drag and dropping, draw out new process flows that we want to run through with this. Now, as you'll see in our presentation, we're more than just a security company sitting over the top of this. Because we're using all this data together, we're now suddenly relevant for a whole heap of different areas, such as customer experience measurement, marketing, operations and safety. So this is really our visualization lens. So sitting over the top of this, we can also represent this data as part of digital twins or GIS indoor and outdoor mapping. You can then search for events and do video analytics. So this is a complete collection. We also run brief cam as just one of the options that sits in here via Synopsis. So we have a whole wide range of different analytics, because what we're finding is that organizations have to go out to vendor A for license plate, vendor B for vehicle make and model, vendor C for weapon recognition, and it just keeps going on and on. So what we've done is brought them all together on the one platform. Now, the platform is then very powerful because, as you'll see here, this guy here has got a lot of shadowing over his face, so we could essentially pull that picture in and we go, oh, there's a problem there. So then what we do is we send it back to lighting correction to go, hey, can you do some work on this for me, and then send it to facial. So the same thing would apply for license plates as well. So we send that license plate, or in this case the face, off to lighting correction, and we then get a better result. And so that way the in this case, facial recognition engine will get a better outcome because we've improved the lighting. And as I say, we can do the same for license plate recognition alone. Here we have one of the license, well, actually any AI models all have biases in some way, shape or form. They all perform really well in certain situations. So here we've got a situation with license plate recognition or facial recognition, whereby we believe that it's best to actually use more than one engine because of their strengths and weaknesses. And so what you'll find is that we can then send a particular image off to more than one engine, or in this case we could send a face off to six engines all in parallel. And then on the other side of this, our correlator then says, well, four out of the five engines or four out of the six engines believe this is Fred Nurk. And so hence we've now got a much stronger outcome. So the platforms all get around providing high levels of accuracy. Now, it doesn't mean that you need to have buy six facial recognition engines or six license plate recognition engines, because we use the company's SDK to do this work. So you essentially get more than one, certainly for the same price as you pay for one. Now, artificial intelligence is more than just security, and so I'll just give you some examples here. As I mentioned earlier, we are a recognition platform company, so on the platform we have a whole heap of different, in fact we've got 40 or 50 different AI engines that can run from a single camera feed coming into Milestone, where we split it out. So in the first case here, we've got safety equipment recognition. So we're recognizing that this person is wearing their safety equipment, safety helmet, safety glasses and safety vest, and now we can do something about that. As an example, someone didn't have that information. So I'm going from a safety application now into a marketing application. You'll see more about this shortly. So here we're recognizing that a particular person is driving a Nissan Altima in the US, and we then talk to the billboard guys and go, hey, there's a Nissan Altima in lane 3. They change their billboard to go, hey, you're in the Nissan Altima, you should upgrade the Chevy Malibu. It's got more safety features in your car. Here we've got aircraft turnaround tracking, so we're using AI coming off Milestone. We're pulling in a video feed, and now we can predict when this aircraft's going to be ready to go, because we've worked out that the chocks that are on the plane, the fuel trucks arrived, and the meal truck and so on. Amazingly enough, we can now recognize your heart rate, stress level, blood oxygenation level, respiration rate just by pointing a camera at you now. So this is very powerful information for healthcare, but also for security, for recognizing that someone's stressed, perhaps walking through an airport. Now, one of the big things about a platform approach is, as well, is we can do things such as multi-factor recognition. So here what I see, I've stopped here, and this vehicle here has a lot of mud over its license plate, making it very hard to see. So by recognizing the license plate through previous visits by this vehicle, recognizing its license plate, and also working on its make and model and color, year and manufacture, and also Bluetooth and Wi-Fi signals potentially coming from this vehicle, we can now associate all these things together, and that way if we can't read the license plate, we go, it doesn't matter. There's enough strength in the other factors for me to know that the license plate is ABC123. So here we outperform individual applications such as license plate alone, because we've got more things to work with to, once again, improve accuracy. Next up, we have demographic recognition. So this young lady here has walked into a room. Now we're working out her age and height or her demographic, and now we're suggesting products to her. And these are all touch screens. She can walk around, select the product she's interested in, and off they go to a shopping basket. Here we're using two recognition technologies together, facial recognition and behavior recognition. So now we can work out that this is Josh and he's graffitiing the wall. And so rather than just knowing that it's Josh or knowing that it's a person who's graffitiing the wall, we're got two engines working together. Here we're doing power line recognition, so we've got lasers pointed outside the helicopter telling this helicopter or the cameras where to focus to lock in on the power lines. And now we can recognize broken strands, damaged insulators, all while this helicopter is flying along at 100 k's an hour, 4 hours at a time. People counting sensors, so these sensors point directly down, and so we can now do queue length, dwell time and customer experience levels and lots of different things, people counting. With this camera. Next up we have gesture recognition. This young lady here is holding her hands above the lemons, and on the screens above we go, these lemons come from New Zealand, this is a nutritional breakdown, so what cooked for dinner with them tonight, and some wine and some fish will go really nicely with those lemons. Next up, we have a bag left at a train station. It's been there too long, so we need to do something about that. Now, is it sinister in its intent? So just by drawing a box around it, we can then quickly highlight, hey, that person was left by a little old lady, so obviously she's just forgotten it. And so now we can then know what to do with that. Lastly, this is where we see vision-based AI really going. We're driving much more contextual insights now than saying, hey, we've seen a truck, because now what we're starting to tell you is what we're actually seeing in a lot more detail to give you that rich insights. So as you'll see here, we're saying a FedEx truck is driving in the driveway or alley. This is a US video. Then he's parked in front of the house. A man walks around the corner holding a box. He puts the box down. He picks up the bag. He puts the bag down. And then he knocks on the door. So, as I say, much more contextual insight. So hopefully that's given you some ideas around some of the things you can now do with AI and recognition technologies. So how do we scale artificial intelligence with Milestone? Because there are so many engines out there. So what we do is we can pull in a number of feeds from cameras into Milestone, and using the RTSP pass-through, we can then split that feed off and into a wide range of different analytics, as you can see here. So this could be off to weapons recognition, demographic recognition, heart rate recognition. We can send a feed to brief cam, vehicle make and model color. We have a capture engine for pulling out still images. So there's a number of AI engines in here, and this gives us the ability to pull off from the one feed, thereby scaling. Because it's path through coming through Milestone, it means that there's really very little overhead on Milestone having to recreate, or it's not actually recreating, it's just passing that feed directly through. And this means that we're placing very low level of load onto Milestone. Because we can then, using the SDK, tweak that video feed that we push out or we pass through, it means then that we can start to send video feeds off to the hyperscalers such as Amazon, Azure, Google Cloud, enabling us to them to ingest or customers to utilize AI models running on those platforms. Now, before you think, oh, does that mean you need a server for each of these analytics? That's not actually the case, because sitting over the top of this, we would run containerization or virtualization, giving us the ability to really scale these environments. And this means we can do things like have self-healing. If one engine fails, we can easily spin up a new container and that engine's then back up and running again very quickly. We can build fault tolerance into here, so we're then not so reliant on one box failing. They all work together as sort of an ecosystem to deliver the payload that the customer's looking for. So the next topic we're going to go through is our vehicle make, model, color, and year of manufacture analytics overview. So just give you some, we'll talk about how this works in this situation where we're doing this for a billboard company. And then we're going to, in the next section, we'll play you a couple of videos so you can see how that works. So what we're essentially doing is using artificial intelligence to recognize each vehicle that drives down the road. Here you'll see we've got a Porsche Cayenne driving down the road, and we've worked out the temperature and the speed that the vehicle is going, the date and time. So it's giving us rich information about this particular vehicle. Obviously then we can use that information to provide the customer with a wide range of different analytics so they can make informed decisions, perhaps about advertising for vehicles. So I want to target all drivers of Porsche Cayennes, which I can then do through this particular approach. And perhaps I want to then say, well, I only want to target them on sunny days, because maybe I'm advertising a particular product that's relevant to Porsche drivers on sunny days. But it could also be time of day, so we can use this, and this feeds into a technology called programmatic marketing, whereby people can bid on what the vehicles they want to target as they drive down the road. So the way this works is we mount a camera on the billboard, we pull a video feed into Milestone, and then using the pass through, we send off to our vehicle capture system. And so we're pulling vehicles out of the feed, and then sending off to the vehicle recognition engine, which goes, oh, that is a Porsche Cayenne, if I use the example we provided before. So what we're actually doing though here is we're actually, once we identify a vehicle that we want from the vehicle capture system, we go and make a request back through the SDK and say, can you please now give me a high resolution feed or image of this vehicle, which is being pulled out of the video frame and sent to our vehicle recognition engine, where we can perform make sure that we're delivering a very high level accuracy. Our billboard customers then query our vehicle recognition engine and say, what are the last vehicles you've seen? And we provide that to them. And then all the data that's collected, you'll see shortly, goes into our video analytics and dashboard platform. So we mount a camera up on a billboard such as this one here. This is one of the first ones we did, whereby we're using a pan tilt zoom camera. We did move to PTZ because it made it easier to make the slight adjustments you need to do to the field of view of the camera. And essentially we're streaming directly into Milestone X Protect video management system from this camera. Then the next thing that happens is through the pass-through from Milestone, we go to our vehicle capture engine, which locates the vehicle within the video frame. So you can see the blue bounding box we have here. Essentially what we're doing is saying, whenever a vehicle comes into this blue bounding box, I want you to go and grab that vehicle, work out that it's a vehicle, and then we go and send a request back to Milestone saying, can you please now give us a high resolution feed from this particular frame and from these coordinates within the frame, so that we could then get a really high resolution image to send off to the video, the recognition engine. This way, by doing this, we're only then sending the high resolution feeds as required, and we're not having to send very high resolution feeds off to the vehicle recognition engine. So to make it work super hard, this is all done as a way to minimize latency, because it's very important, obviously, with vehicles speeding down the road, to turn this thing around quickly. So once we've captured that vehicle, then we're working out its make, model, color, and year of manufacture. Now, I should mention here that year of manufacture is subject to the change. How we work that out is each vehicle typically changes its shape every 3 to 4 years. So it's not a precise science. We're basically looking at the front of the vehicle and going, well, I know that vehicle changed to that shape, say, between 2013 and 2016. And that gives us the ability to do approximate year of manufacturer. Now, we may then also optimize the image further again by cropping it down further, because we've worked out this is a vehicle. We're really interested in just the front grille of the vehicle, rather than sending, the bigger the image we send off to the vehicle make and model recognition engine, the more pixels it's got to work through to try and work out what this vehicle is. So the better we can do that cropping, the faster that algorithm works, which is really important when you've got vehicles like campaigns we did in the US, where vehicles are speeding down the road 120 k's an hour, and we have to then target them and do billboard advertising. The latency is critical for the success of this. Once we've done that, then the system looks in its database and says, yep, I've got a match. Now, I'm just showing a one-to-one here, but essentially we need sort of 100 images of each vehicle make and model. We've got a vehicle database which has thousands of different vehicles in it. We're doing a match and then going, okay, yeah, based on this, we now know that it's a Porsche vehicle. So the hundreds of vehicles collected, we need to try and capture them in different lighting conditions, different angles offset from the vehicle. So that gives us a bit of flexibility and a bit of fault tolerance to deal with the fact we can't always get camera field of views. So they're pointing directly onto the vehicle so that we update the training to try and make a match. The system's very, very, surprisingly very accurate. When I say surprisingly, I'm talking about the angle. So often on the billboards, we'll come in from quite a side angle, and even doing so, we can still get very good accuracy with the vehicle make and model recognition engine. Accuracy is sort of in the high 90% mark. So once we've done that, then our customers are sending us an API request on a frequent basis. We return the last 10 vehicles we've seen with their level of confidence. And they go, yep, I'm targeting a Porsche driver. So in this particular case here, they would then change the billboard to go, hey, you in the Porsche. As you'll see, they'll put a message up. It's easy to pick you out from the crowd. Now, one of the things that really excites the billboard companies is the ability to understand and count vehicles. So not only are we recognising the make and model vehicle, we're also counting them, and this gives us the ability to understand and give them heat maps. So perhaps they want to target vehicles at certain times of the day. We can then give them a breakdown by make and model of vehicle over that same period, which is really interesting because then they can actually go out to the vehicle manufacturers and say, hey, did you know we saw this number of Mercedes-Benz vehicles? And so they can then target them with advertising encourages Mercedes-Benz, in this particular case as the example, to then sign up the billboard company saying, well, I want to target them, or perhaps they want to target competitive vehicles to Mercedes. So let's talk about a couple of use cases, personalized and relevant billboard advertising. So what I'm going to do now is play you a couple of videos. The first one is from Lexus. So Lexus did a campaign here in Australia. So we'll just let that run. And the next video I'm going to play you is from Paramount Studios. So this was a campaign we did in the US for the launch of the Transformer 5 movie, funny enough. And so what would happen then is as you're driving down the road, we work out that you're in a Nissan Altima, and then we mention, the billboard guys change the billboard to say, hey, you in the Nissan Altima, we believe your car is a Decepticon, which is the bad robot from Transformer 5, so that we then encouraging them to report alien activity, but was really just a way of building brand awareness for the launch of this particular movie. So we did a number of billboards like this across the US. So next use case is, and the last one for you, is high accuracy vehicle recognition utilizing multi-factor vehicle recognition. So I mentioned during the video I played earlier that by recognizing a number of different factors about vehicles, we can outperform license plate recognition. So multi-factor will always outperform a single factor like license plate simply because we have more factors to deal with now. So if I can't read the license plate, and I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but a lot of people now are starting to print their own plates on 3D printers. And so I could copy anyone's plate if I had a 3D printer, stick it on my car, drive through red light cameras and speed cameras. And so by doing so, it means then that if I went through a red light camera, essentially I'm sending that bill gets sent to the person who actually owns the license plate I copied, which is good for me, but obviously not very good for them. So in this case here, over on the left hand side, this guy drove into a petrol station. He filled up his car with petrol and drove off. Now what he'd done is written a bit of cardboard that put over his license plate that said IOU. And he did that on both the front and the back. He fueled up his car with petrol and then he drove off. Now, this, the fact that he's got his license plate covered, which is a single factor identification, and saying IOU, they had no hope of trying to work out what its license plate is. But in our case, what we're doing is recognizing, perhaps we've seen this vehicle before, we know that it's a silver Subaru Impreza 1996 model. The license plate is ABC123, and potentially we can also pick up on his Wi-Fi and Bluetooth signals coming from his phone. We're learning all these associations, and that way we go, well, I can't read the license plate, so I now know, but I know through previous learnings that the license plate is ABC123. This guy over here on the right hand side, he put his car on car sales, and he then about a month later, and this is back then, you had to show your license plate. Now he then got a speeding fine about a month later because someone on the Gold Coast had copied his license plate, printed a copy and put it on his car, and then he they drove through a red light camera and he ended up getting the bill for this. Now he clearly had never been to the Gold Coast, and so he's able to prove that that was the case, and he was able to avoid the fine. But it's just showing you the growing amount of problems that exist with just relying solely on license plate recognition alone. So in the case of deep recognition, we recognize the person's license plate. We can also do re-ID. So basically we look for various features about the vehicle, stickers and bull bars as I've got down the bottom, and anything. It could be an antenna, it could be bull bars. So re-ID enables us to re-identify that vehicle. Essentially we're trying to make it as unique as possible. Obviously we're recognizing make, model, color. We may be able to pull in e-tag information, approximate year of manufacture, its location, and also potentially roads authority data about the vehicle, along with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth signals coming from the vehicle. So, you know, we've certainly proven this with a few customers in our ability to improve the accuracy that they were getting off their existing license plate recognition system. We improved the accuracy. So the more you can learn about something, more factors you can gather, the better. So that's it. Thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this presentation. If you'd like any further information regarding this or anything else that deep recognition does, you'll find my email address there. We appreciate the opportunity to present with Milestone, and hope you have a great day. Thank you.